wee trip around the Eurozone and Sweden. Hi there YouTube, it's Big Laurie here with a few bits and pieces of European junk, I suppose you'd call it. You probably all know that virtually half of Europe and the greatest majority of the populace of Europe now use the Euro. A wee economic history lesson, I suppose. Since the way back in the 60s, there have been people, principally the original members of the European Union, as it was originally called, the Common Market. Way back in the 60s, they started talking about sharing a single currency and creating a political and economic union. And as everything in Europe, certainly politically and economically is concerned, it takes an eternity for them to do anything. Mainly because of the United Kingdom putting the mockers on everything. We want to be part of Europe, but we don't want anything to do with those bloody Europeans. That's the attitude we've always had. But in 1993, the Maastricht Treaty was signed, and it was all about creating monetary and political union by 1999, except for the UK and Denmark. Hey. But so in 1999, they started using the euro, although no formal currency, coins and notes were created until 2002. And so up until then, every single member of the Eurozone had their own currency. And a lot of the older ones are part silver. So these are some bits and pieces that I recently picked up. Start by having a look at a couple of these old Irish ones. 1939 and 1940 florins, so 2 shillings. Now these were 75% silver. I hope that's focusing okay. And this is something that's always brings a smile to your face. It's the way the kind of obverse of all old Irish coins, this harp, the symbol of Ireland. So these ones, I picked up a couple of them, and I can't remember exactly what I paid, but the equivalent spot price was under £9 per ounce. So it's, you know me, not often I get anything close to double spot, let alone underneath spot, so really, really chuffed with these ones. So, there you go, a couple of Irish. Let's quickly jump on a plane and skip over to Greece, maybe the Greek islands. I sent one of these, I bought a couple of them, and I sent one over to our boy, Frank P, just a couple of weeks ago. It's a 1960 Greek 20 drachma, or drachmai, I think it was in Greek. You'll forgive me, my Greek's not great. 0.835 silver, and no doubt, I think in 1960 they still had a monarchy. I don't think there was a military junta until the early 70s. Oh yeah, we have them over here, not just South America. But that one's a lovely, lovely coin. Recently picked up a couple of these, 1916 and 1950 centime coins from France. Sorry, is that focusing? Yeah, just about. And these are beautiful little coins. Again, 0.835 silver. And everyone in the States will no doubt recognise this image. It's quite a lot of imagery close between the French and the US. I can't think why. '76 and all that malarkey. But yeah, the French eventually came and they brought the weapons to allow the colonials to finally claim their freedom from the Brits. If only the American government had been so decent about our liberty 2 or 3 years ago when we were having our, last year when we were having our referendum, and Obama made it quite clear how he thought about it. Rat bag. But yeah, both these are quite nice, Nick. And obviously this symbol It's the French equivalent, I guess, of Lady Liberty. Liberté, fraternité, égalité, liberty, brotherhood, and equality, which is quite a nice way of looking at things. A couple of Dutch ones as well. These ones are just one guilder, which was the old currency they used before the euro, and these 72% silver. Again, I can't remember who this is, but they are the same kind of guff that we do in ours. They have a nominal royal family, although they don't have any of the pomp and circumstance that we do in the UK. They're kind of expected to go out and have a proper job, which is quite encouraging. Yes, in 1956, 1958, these ones 72%. And nice coins. I'm really, really chuffed. These I picked up all fairly reasonably over the last few weeks. Most of them just on eBay. Couple quid here and there, so quite chuffed. And although Sweden are nothing to do with the Eurozone, this one, it's just a 40% as well from 1944. You'll forgive me, any of you Swedish speaking people, 50 ora. But I'm very unsure about pronunciation. I think in Sweden, an A with a couple of dots above it is pronounced O. So God knows what an O with a couple of dots over it is pronounced. So forgive me, anybody who speaks Swedish. And this one from 1944. And again, the old symbol, the crown, because they have a monarchy as well. But give that one last little look there, because it's nothing to do with the Eurozone. And so yeah, I'm quite pleased with these ones. Picked these up, as I say, over the last few weeks, and it's nice to pick it up reasonable, close to spot, you know, not too much above it. Anyway, let us know what you think. These are a few from what we used to have before the Eurozone. Francs in France, guilder in the Netherlands, drachma in Greece, the old punt, which was the equivalent of a pound in Ireland, and obviously the, I think it was a krona, so I think 50 ora, you got 100 of those to the krona, I believe. Anyway, I'm rambling on. Time I was going on, so please let us know what you think. Your comments is always good, bad, indifferent, always welcome. And please like and subscribe. And I'll speak to you soon. You take care. Bye-bye.